Classes. Classes are a fundamental building block of object-oriented programming. In fact, Kotlin classes are very similar to Java classes. Kotlin, however, allows more functionality together with simpler and much more concise syntax. Class declaration. Classes in Kotlin are defined using the class keyword. The following is the simplest class declaration: an empty class named person. Definition of person does not contain any body. Still, it can be instantiated using a default constructor. Even such a simple task as class instantiation is simplified in Kotlin. Unlike Java, Kotlin does not require the new keyword to create a class instance. Due to strong Kotlin interoperability with Java, we can instantiate classes defined in Java and Kotlin exactly the same way. The syntax used to instantiate a class depends on the actual language used to create class instance, not the language the class was declared in. It is the rule of thumb to use the new keyword inside a Java file and never use the new keyword inside a Kotlin file. Properties. Property is just a combination of a backing field and its accessors. It could be a backing field with both a getter and a setter, or a backing field with only one of them. Properties can be defined at the top level or as a member. In general, it is advisable to define properties instead of accessing public fields directly. Java getter and setter conventions for private fields. Getter, a parameterless method with a name that corresponds to property name and a get prefix. Setter, single argument methods with names starting with set, for example, set result. Kotlin guards this principle by language design, because this approach provides various encapsulation benefits. Ability to change internal implementation without changing an external API. Enforces invariance ability to perform additional actions when accessing member. To define a top-level property, we simply define it in the Kotlin file. Let's imagine that we need a class to store basic data regarding a person. This data may be downloaded from an external API or retrieved from a local database. Our class will have to define two properties, name and age. Let's look at the Java implementation first. This class contains only two properties. Since we can make the Java IDE generate accessors code for us, at least we don't have to write the code by ourselves. However, the problem with this approach is that we cannot get along without these automatically generated chunks, and that makes the code very verbose. We spend most of our time just reading the code, not writing it, so reading redundant code wastes a lot of valuable time. Also, a simple task such as refactoring the property name becomes a little bit trickier, because the IDE might not update constructor parameter names. Fortunately, boilerplate code can be decreased significantly by using Kotlin. Kotlin solves this problem by introducing the concept of properties that is built into the language. Let's look at a Kotlin equivalent of the preceding Java class. This is an exact equivalent of the preceding Java class. The constructor method is equivalent of the Java constructor that is called when an object instance is created. Getters and setters are generated by the Kotlin compiler. We can still define custom implementations of getters and setters. We will discuss this in more detail in the custom getters and setters section. All the constructors that we have already defined are called secondary constructors. Kotlin also provides alternative, very concise syntax for defining constructors. We can define a constructor as part of the class header. This kind of constructor is called a primary constructor. Let's move a property declaration from the secondary constructor into the primary constructor to make our code a little bit shorter. In Kotlin, the primary constructor, as opposed to the secondary constructor, can't contain any code, so all initialization code must be placed inside the initializer block. An initializer block will be executed during class creation, so we can assign constructor parameters to fields inside it. To simplify code, we can remove the initializer block and access constructor parameters directly in property initializers. This allows us to assign constructor parameters to a field. We managed to make the code shorter, but it still contains a lot of boilerplate, because type declarations and property names are duplicated. When properties does not have any custom getters or setters, we can define them directly inside primary constructor by adding val or var modifier. Finally, if the primary constructor does not have any annotations or visibility modifiers, then the constructor keyword can be omitted. When the constructor takes a few parameters, it is good practice to define each parameter in a new line to improve code readability and decrease chance of potential merge conflicts. Summing up, the preceding example is equivalent of the Java class presented at the beginning of this section. Both properties are defined directly in the class primary constructor, and Kotlin compiler does all the work for us. It generates appropriate fields and accessors. Note that this notation contains only the most important information about this data model class: its name, parameter names, types, and mutability information. Implementation has nearly zero boilerplate. This makes the class very easy to read, understand, and maintain. Read-write versus read-only property. All the properties in the previous examples were defined as read-write. To define read-only properties, we need to use the val keyword, so only getter will be generated. Let's look at a simple example. Property access syntax between Kotlin and Java. Another big improvement introduced by Kotlin is the way of accessing properties. In Java, we would access property using the corresponding method. Kotlin promotes property access syntax, which is a more expressive way of accessing properties. Let's compare both approaches, assuming we have a simple car class that has a single speed property. As we can see, in Kotlin there is no need to add get, set prefixes and parentheses to access or modify an object property. Using property access syntax allows for direct usage of increment and decrement operators together with property access. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to our channel and give a thumbs up. It helps our channel a lot. Thank you. See you in the next episode.